Andrew Clatworthy's first car was a hand-me-down from his mum. It started a passion for remodelling, and he's had 70 more cars since then, not including those he's done up for clients. And as Doug Murray found, the hobby needed a special wife, and now their business is thriving in a most unlikely location.
A Thornlands poultry farm must rate as the weirdest address for a motor car beauty shop and panel works.
Yes, you certainly don't find it by accident.
I was confused. I thought I took the wrong turn off and I couldn't find reverse gear quick enough.
We sometimes be working away inside the shed here and we'll hear a car pull up, and before we can walk out the door, the car's going back out the gate again. So normally we think, well, if that's what you think of us, we don't want you here anyhow.
Andrew Clatworthy lives for cars. As well, wife Kim is a keen panel beater. Household furniture is made from recycled car bodies. The family photo album reveals a convoy of amazing hot rods and jalopies.
I used to sit under the house with my matchbox cars and I would laboriously panel beat them all, much to my mother's disgust.
Andrew's panel beating skills are on show throughout the home.
There's a lot of unfinished projects around the place, just waiting for his magic touch.
Kim's 1958 FC Holden is virtually unrecognisable.
It's been two-doored. The doors have been lengthened 6 inches. It's had a grille change. The headlights have been altered.
The blue bus, called Mislead, has won a swag of radical custom trophies at motor shows across the country.
But I'm not allowed to take it to the school, I'm not allowed to go to the doctors, I'm not allowed to go to the shopping centre.
When Andrew's not tending chooks, there's a battery of rusting Holdens waiting for the kiss of life.
Oh, it's his love, it's his passion, yes.
Delma gifted her son his first car, a HG Holden Ute, which he modified and eventually sold.
For 7 years, I annoyed the girl that I sold it to sell it back to me. She wouldn't sell.
He got it back. It's the current project, stripped bare, waiting for another facelift. Whenever there's a pause between paying customers.
And they do see Andrew's work at car shows, and that starts asking questions and you get led here.
They're not only doing this as a job, but they're quite interested in the vehicles themselves and put a lot of effort into it and take, I think, get just as much pleasure as I do out of the good job that they do.
Just generate enough income through customer work to keep the doors open.
This is not a place for run-of-the-mill fender benders. For a special job, it's worth a trip to the Chook Farm.
There's just so many more cars to build. There's just so many more ideas I just haven't used up.
Yes, amazing cars. Well, now to a couple of